Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 21st of 2021, well, it is titled Colors, Ring Nebula versus Stars. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image showing the Ring Nebula, which is an example of a planetary nebula, which is what happens at the end of the life of a star, much like our own sun, where the outer layers are expelled out into space and the core contracts down to become a white dwarf. Now, if it looks a little bit different and seems to be multiple images of it here, that is correct. And the reason is, if you look at all the stars, you can see how their images are stretched out as well. And what we're actually looking at is an image of a spectrum of that star. Now, a spectrum occurs when we use something like a prism or a diffraction grating, which is used to separate light into its component colors. If we look at many sources of light, say such as our own sun, we would see roughly a continuous spectrum. And that would be all the colors of the rainbow from red here on the left through violet. So you can see all of those in the streaks of the star where that light has been spread out. However, you notice that the Ring Nebula is a little different. We only see a couple images of it. Now we see the Ring Nebula here primarily in two colors, and you see those as the red and the blue, red being emission due to hydrogen gas and blue being due to oxygen. So those are the two primary ones. And then off to the right, you see one that's a little more color combined, put colors together to be what you would normally see. So why would we want to split the colors up like this? Why would we want multiple images? Well, the spectrum of a star is really where we learn everything we can about us, about stars and other objects. Without that, with just looking at the continuous spectrum of an object, we can learn things like its temperature. But when we want to learn other details, especially the compositions of the stars, we need to be able to spread it out into its component colors and look for lines. Bright lines or dark lines will tell us what that object is made up of. So how do we know what the Ring Nebula is made up of when we can't actually go out there and get a sample of it to study in the laboratory? Well, we can see what colors it is emitting, and that will tell us those specific wavelengths are tied to very specific elements. So we can learn about how much hydrogen it has in that nebula, how much oxygen and other elements that may be present within that nebula. We can use a similar thing to learn about stars. So we can learn about those. We can learn about how fast it is moving, how those lines are shifted. What we call the Doppler effect tells us how fast things are moving either towards or away from us. And we can also in part use them to get distances to the stars. So being able to split things up into their component colors through spectroscopy like this is a way that we learn a lot of what we know about objects out there in space that we have no chance of ever being able to visit. So that was our picture of the day for July the 21st of 2021. It was titled Colors, Ring Nebula versus Stars. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.